Welcome and hello to a further webinar with the topic KNX Style Gateway Premium, New Application Version 2.0. My name is Thorsten Reibel from the Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings. Yeah, and together with me is Jürgen Schilder. He will present today. Our webinar will take around 1 hour. Together with us is also the product manager, Gerd Schlag, and he will help us in answering your questions. I hand over to Jürgen now. He will continue.
Hello and welcome. Jürgen Schilder is speaking. In today's webinar, I'm going to introduce you the new application program 2.0 for the ABB iBus KNX Starly Gateway Premium DGS X6451. There is no new hardware. By updating the application program to the version 2.0, new functions are available. What is on the agenda? I will start with an introduction on DALI. Then we come to the new functions like device type 8, color control, the commissioning of color control devices, sequencers, and so on. Followed by the enhancements of the ABB iBus tool, and finally, how to make an update of the firmware and ETS application. Let me start with some words about DALI. DALI is a worldwide standard according to IEC 62386, and it was developed as an industrial standard for intelligent and easy management of lighting equipment. Some years ago, there were some changes from DALI to DALI 2. Why? Because there were some extensions for control devices, new commands when necessary, and very important, a higher quality standard. So today, a DALI 2 device must be tested with the equipment and show the compliance with the specifications. And then the device wears this DALI 2 logo. So we recommend to use only DALI 2 ballast or drivers, because DALI 2 guarantees the improvement capability of all DALI components. And of course, our DALI gateways, the DGS Premium and Basic 1 or 2-fold, follows according this DALI 2 standards. And you can visit the website of the DALI Illumination Interface Alliance. This is the official name. The website DALI-Alliance.org, and then you will get, of course, a wide range of information about DALI, DALI 2, and you can go to the product database and see the list of DALI 2 certified devices like our DALI gateways. So DALI 2 means that we have to look that we should have a look on the DALI device types. The new one, like for example, DALI device type 0 means it's the part 201 for fluorescence lamps, which is similar like DALI device type 6, part 207 for LED modules. The DALI device type 1 is for self-contained emergency lighting converter. And now today we put a focus on the DALI device type 8, part 209 for color control or color temperature control. Like the typical color temperature, TC, tunable white, the RGB, RGBW, or also XY coordinates. This is all specified in the part 209. And on the right side, you can see a screenshot of a presentation, which you can find on the website of the DALI. For the DALI Association, and here is exactly this part 201 for the fluorescence lamps and 209 for our device types 8. So then let's have a look back on the history of the ABB iBus KNX DALI gateways. What was before May 2021? We launched our first DALI gateway in the year 2005, the so-called DGS 81, which works with 8 channels as broadcast. And this device is still available on the market. Then we followed with a DALI gateway 1.1 for individual control of 64 devices, followed by the group-oriented gateway 161 and the DALI gateway for emergency lighting converters. But these all devices are now discontinued and the successor is our DALI gateway basic or premium. Then we launched in 2010 the DALI Light Controller as a DIN-REL component and 2013 for a decentralized installation. So in the year 2017, we started with a new generation of DALI gateways, so-called DALI Gateway Basic with one channel, two channel for single or group-oriented controlling, including the emergency ballasts. So then, 3 years later, 2020, we launched the DALI Gateway Premium, which is here a 5 in the middle. 5 means this is the premium version with one channel, two channels, the same feature, 64 devices for individual, group control, emergency converter, plus some features of device type 8 for color temperature. And of course, all these devices are available in the market. So in the DALI Gateway Premium, two hardware versions with one channel or two channel, two independent outputs. There are two DALI power supplies inside and both devices supports the standard normie DALI ballast, device type 0, 6, the emergency converters, device type 1, and the color control DALI device type 8 for temperature control, color temperature. And the wide range of functions like flexible combination of groups or single control, IBAS tools. We have the templates, which helps us and save time during commissioning, and functions like dim to warm or human-centric lighting and standby switch off. We have given numerous webinars, online sessions, and trainings about this, about all our DALI gateways. And you can find the webinar recordings and the presentation slides in our training and qualification database, which you get on our website, the link, and this link you will also find in our feedback email. So what is color temperature? TC means that it's possible to change the temperature of the light. Yeah, here you see between warm white and cold white. So we need for this application special device type 8 DALI drivers with the color temperature TC function. So some functions of this color temperature is the human-centric lighting. So like we can use it in the morning that we have warm light, like the sun is rising in the morning, and the afternoon we have more cold light, and the evening again warm. So the natural behavior of the sun outside. Or to use the dim to warm functions. Dim to warm, we simulate the behavior of a typical traditional incandescent lamps. So when you dim an incandescent lamp darker, it gets more warm, for example, 2000 Kelvin, and with dimming brighter, it becomes more cold. And this behavior exactly we can also simulate with the dim to warm function of our DALI gateways. So like special for a residential home in the evening, it is really a nice feature. So plus some functions like to reduce the energy cost, so-called standby switch off if all ballasts or all lights are off, to switch off here the ballast and get no ballast failure. There's a function here in our DALI gateway. And other functions like the templates or the long frame supports during a download. Yeah, so we can make a download faster if we use long frame telegrams. So, and we have also here our IBAS tool, and a nice feature in our IBAS tool is to detect here an unknown ballast by maximum 6 clicks. So we can start, and every time you say yes, your ballast is on or not, and so after the step number 6, you can identify the address, the DALI short address of your lamp, which really makes the commissioning faster. So this was before May 2, 2021. So, and now what we have done in June is we have launched a new software application with the version 2.0. So then we can use our existing DALI gateways premium, DALI gateway 1 or 2-fold, 64.5.1, and we can make a download and update this version 1.0, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3 or 1.4 to the version 2.0, and then we have new software functions. So this is really new that we use an existing hardware, and via an application update, we have more and new functions. Like here with the version 2.0, we have more extended functions like the DALI device type 8 for RGB, W control, sequencer, load shedding, and some more nice features, which I show you now step by step. So this here is the overview of some new functions with the software application 2.0, like DALI device type 8, the color control, RGB, RGBW for the white function, HSV and HSV white. So we have also 4 sequencers, load shedding, the operation duration we get per ballast or per group, and some nice features for name of ballast and groups, which I show you also step by step. And of course, enhancements in the ABB IBAS tool. So what is also a great feature is that when you update an existing DALI gateway, which is maybe parameterized and in commissioning, the complete parameterization and the group addresses can be taken over. So normally when you update a new application version to a device, the former parameterization, the group addresses, everything is deleted. But now we have a possibility to convert the version 1.4 into the 2.0, and all the group addresses and parameterization is taken over to save a lot of time and do not make, for example, mistakes and so on. So, and now, of course, our new devices here from the factories are delivered with the application program 2.0. But maybe when you order it from a wholesaler, then it's possible that you can give, for example, a version 1.4, and then you can make the update, which I show you later, step by step. So some words about this so-called device type 8, color control. What does it mean? Of course, our DALI Gateway Premium supports the color control switching devices or ballast with the device type 8 according to this IEC standard. So the devices have multiple channel, like for example here on the right side, you can see such a typical device type 8 RGBW driver. The device has only a single address, it's only one DALI address, but here in the output you can see multiple channel. Like here the device has four outputs, one is for red, one is for green, one is for blue, and the other one is for white. Or here on the right side, this is a typically tunable white temperature color DALI driver from the device type 8. The same device, the device has also only one address, but two outputs. Here an output for warm white and for the cold white LED strips. What we also support is a so-called HSV white color control, but this here, this HSV is based on RGBW, because on the market there are no HSV ballast available. So we use RGB ballast, and via calculation we can adapt it here to HSV, which I show you also later. So some words about this tunable white. What is it? We talk here about warm and cold white of the like here typical residential home, the living room. Like here maybe in the afternoon we can have here really cold white, about 6500 Kelvin, and maybe in the evening when watching here television you want to have a nice atmosphere, and then you can maybe change the color temperature here to 3000 Kelvin. Then we talk about here warm white. And in the middle, between 3 and 5,000 Kelvins, we talk about neutral light. So this is what we can do with this tunable white temperature color. So now what is RGBW? It means that we have here the three primary colors, red, green, and blue. And now we mix these different colors. This is the complete trick. So by mixing the color, we get here, for example, some other colors. Like when we mix 100% red and 100% green, and 0% blue, then we have here yellow. So, and by mixing these colors, so many percent of red, so many percent of blue, so many percent of green, we get here a wide range of colors. Like you see it here, maybe in a square, we have here green, red, and blue, and then you have here a point. Maybe this is a kind of light green or dark green. Yeah, so many percent red, so many percent green, and so many percent of blue. So when we mix all three colors with full 100%, then we have theoretically white, like here in the middle means 100% red, 100% green, and 100% blue. But this is not really a perfect white. That's why nowadays on the market there are LED strips with four colors, red, green, blue, and white. So-called, that's why we have here in brackets the W. So three is standard, but today it's quite common to have here four colors RGBW. The advantage is that if you want white, you switch only on the white LED, and the other LEDs, the red, green, and blue, are off. So only one LED, maybe a strip, is on to save also here some energy. And you have really a better white. Good, here on the right side, you can see such a typical RGBW LED strip. You have here the RGB LED, RGB here in one LED, and the yellow one is the white LED. And here we have the five cores, the common plus, and then the minus for red, green, blue, and for white. And of course, there are also other RGB numbers, like for example here together with amber or other colors, but these are special solutions. Today, it's quite common to have this typical RGBW LED spots or LED strips and so on. Another possibility to mix colors is a so-called HSV. So what is it? It is similar like RGB, so we can also calculate between both principles, but maybe for some applications or some system integrators prefer here to use the HSV color control. So what does it mean? At first, we have the so-called U. U means we have here a wheel of 360 degrees, and depending on the position, we have here the color. Like for example, red means we have here we have here 0 degrees. If we want to have the color green, then we have 120 degrees, and the color blue, for example, here is 240 degrees. And between, like for example, between red and green, we have, for example, here 60 degrees, and then we have yellow. So we see it also here in a kind of strip between 0 degrees and 360 or zero again, we have here our U. This is one parameter. Another one is the saturation. Saturation means, for example, how many white color we add here to our to the color. So for example, we have when we here on the outside, then we have no white color, and if we add more white, then it's more pastel, the color. And the third parameter is the so-called value. Value means the value of the brightness. So when we enter full 100% brightness, then we have full 100%, and when we reduce the brightness, then it's get more black. So now we have here three objects, later we see three parameters, U, saturation, and the value. And what you use, you're absolutely free. It depends also your panel or your sensor, which kind of principle RGB or HSV the device uses. So there are maybe some system integrators or some customers, they prefer the so-called HSV because it mimics the human color perception. So that's why it is more preferred. But in principle, we can transform and by the means of a calculation, we can here convert values from RGB in HSV and vice versa. Like here, I have a typical color, and the color in the RGB mode, you see here the values between 0 and 255. At the moment, it's here 177, green 90, 91, and blue 235 equals exactly this color. And if you confirm it or transform it into the HSV, then it's 276 degrees on the wheel, the saturation of 61%, and the brightness of 92%. So this here is a screenshot of the ABB IPAS tool, and later you will also see here this example in the IPAS tool. Yeah, and here are some screenshots of the IPAS tool with the different colors, like for example here red means we have here red 255, 0 green, 0 blue, and here our UA is also 0 degrees, and the saturation and the brightness full 100%. And yellow means we have RGB 255 for red, green 255, and zero here for blue. So red and green equals yellow. And if you compare it here with our HSV, then we have 60 degrees and full saturation and full brightness value. And the same you can here see for purple, for blue, and for green, and so on. Good, so with our DALI gateway, we have full flexibility for controlling devices according to RGB or HSV. We have group objects for individual control of the group and ballast, so we can control and mix the color per group, per ballast. Also for dimming, so we can dim between the color and set also values, maybe go to purple or go to yellow and so on. And we can use the color control function also for the scenes and for the sequencer. Yeah, so please wait, what is the sequencer? Later I will explain it. And the color control is also performed using for the RGB and for the HSV. But do not forget, HSV is based on RGB because we are on the market, they're only RGB ballast. So then we can do, for example, more things like for the color control, we can use a single control. Then we get, for example, four objects, one object here for red, 0 to 255, one for green, one for blue, one for white, or we can use a combined group object, which is a 3-byte. So in the 3 bytes, we have 1 byte for red, 1 byte for green, one byte for blue, or we have a so-called 6-byte, and in the 6-byte, we have again red, green, blue, and additionally also 4 white. So this depends about your panel or sensor what you need, then you can select these three different possibilities for the color control. You see, we have here the highest flexibility in our DALI gateway. So then let's show you an overview of such a typical light control of LED strips. Like here we have LED strips on the output, typically RGBW. So we can see here the RGB LED and the white LED. And the five cores, the common plus 24, the common is typically here with LEDs the plus, and the minus is switched here for red, green, blue and white. So to mix here the colors from your smart touch, for example, or via the room touch, you can see in the room touch you can change here the color like you want, purple, yellow, what you prefer. And you can also use here the push control touch app, and via the app you can also mix the color. So here in the push control touch you see exactly this is the principle of HSV. You see here the slider between 0 and 360 degrees for the UE, the saturation and also the brightness. Exactly this push control touch is based on HSV. So then we need our DALI gateway. DALI gateway receives here the group addresses via 3-byte or 6-byte or via 1-byte, so it depends your parameterization, and controls here a device type 8, red, green, blue, RGB, white, ballast, and the ballast has one address but four outputs for our four colors. This is a typical application that you can mix different colors here via panels, sensors and so on. Here are some pictures of the ABB Room Touch. Room Touch, you can install it horizontally or vertically, like here vertically. Then you click here maybe on your LED spot, which is on the wall, and then the window pops up. And here then you can mix the different colors, and via the slider you can dim the brightness. Or when you install it horizontally, then you maybe have two or three of these elements. And here you see also the status of the color green, and by tapping here, a new window pops up where you can also change then the color like here. Then the window opens and here you can change what you want, purple and so on. And with the slider here up and down, you can change the brightness. So all these things about the room touch and smart touch and color control, I will show you in the further practical learning sessions, which follows after these webinars in the next weeks. So all here the ABB, the push Smart Touch, we have here, for example, a button for RGB control. So when you tap here on this with your finger on this icon, the window pops up and here you can see exactly the HSV principle. We are one slider. You can change here the U between 0 and 360 degrees, the brightness and the saturation. So then let's come to the commissioning of this color function RGBW. So we can set some parameters here in our output A or output B in the templates. So here you see the template functions for all our ballast or groups, or you can make the settings also here in a group or in a ballast. The advantage is when you use here the templates, we can save a lot of time and makes the commissioning easier. And we have here a new submenu, which is RGB white color control template, and these are all the other templates. You know it from the version 1.4 before, and now with the version 2.0 we have here this new submenu color control template. So we have, when you click here on the color control template, then we get here the parameters. At first we get here the parameter control via KNX, how we want to use the color control format, with RGB without brightness, RGB, the color and the brightness, or the HSV, the UE saturation and the value. So this is the first question, and then we can set some more parameters, like when switching on, for example, to use here the last color value or default value, a fixed value, for example, and the transition time to reach the value, or to permit switching on via a color setting, for example, or to use the combined groups, or for the dimming, the speed, for example, and also the status, if you want to have the status, yes or no, as a 3-byte or also as a 6-byte. These are the typical parameters I would like to explain you in one of the following practical learning sessions. So then let's come to this first parameter we have, the color control, the format. When you select RGB, only color, no brightness, then you can directly control these three channels. Or four channels. It depends on the next parameter. Next parameter, you can say, okay, you have RGB or you have also RGB white. So when you say RGB white, then you get four objects for dimming, typical 4-bit dimmings for dimming red, dimming green, dimming blue, dimming white, and for setting the value, like a one byte between 0, 100% for red, green, blue, white. So you can use here a standard control element, a standard push element, which can used for dimming or for sending a value and control here our LED strips. So this is a basic function of all standard control element. So another possibility is to use, for example, here at RGB. If you have the RGB and the brightness control. So brightness control means then you get here another parameter, or another group object for the relative dimming and of the brightness and the brightness value here as a one byte. So when you say, okay, I prefer to use this HSV color format, U saturation and value, then you get the group object here for relative dimming U, for relative dimming saturation, for the brightness and for white. And for setting a value, the U value you see here is a data point type angle. Remember, the U is between 0 and 360 degrees. So we follow here exactly the KNX data point types, and the saturation and the brightness here is between 0 and 100%. So, and with the next parameter, outputs ballast with white or not white. If you say yes with white, RGB four colors, and then you get every time the object, another object for dimming white and for value white. So then let's come to a very nice feature, the so-called sequencer. Yeah, what is a sequencer? Sequencer can be used for maybe, I think, light effects, make it easier. Yeah, it's a kind of scene control, or also for ballast or for groups, which can make different steps. So like in our, I explain it now, in our we have totally four sequencers available per output. You can enable the sequencer, and then you can say how many steps you would to have, we would like to have per sequencer. Maximum, we can have 10 steps, step number 1 to 10. It depends how many steps you enable here, between 1 and 10, and a so-called end step. So why we have an end step and not only full 11 steps? You can enter here another parameter in this parameter field, the number of cycles. You can say, okay, when this sequencer is triggered via 1-bit telegram, the sequencer is now started. And when you enter here the number 5, and then he will doing 5 cycles. So he starts with the first step, then the second step, step number 3, step number 10, and then he goes back to the first one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 10. So, and then after 5 cycles, he comes to this end step. And with the end step, for example, you can switch the light completely off. This is why we say this is our typical end step. Or if you say here 0, then you have no limits of cycles, then he's running endless. And then when you send a group address with the value 0, the sequencer stops. And if you say perform the end step, yes, then he jumps to the end step and is doing here the end step and, for example, switches off the light. So in such a typical sequencer, you can use a group, like for example here, my group number 6, or you can also apply a scene, like my scene number 3, or a ballast with an address number 36. It can be also here, or the complete output A, for example, at the end, switch off, is possible. And then you can enter here the brightness. If it's a color device type, you can change here the color. So when you click here, a picker pops up where you can select exactly here the color, like here yellow or purple or what you want. And if it's device type 8 color control, like my ballast number 36, then you can enter here the color temperature, like 3000 Kelvin warm white, for example. Another parameter here in the sequencer is the dimming time. So now the step is now active, and then between 1 second, the seed number 3 here, seed number 3 is now now reached the end value. Or if the step number 3, the ballast number 36 reached after 4 seconds his end value of 77% and 3000 kelvins. So then we have the so-called step duration. So now the dimming time and step duration starts immediately at the same time. And after 10 seconds, the next step is now done. So after 200 seconds, the next step. After 40 seconds, the next step. So this is the time how long this step now is active. So we can enter here time between 0 and 65,500 and so on. So each of these four scenes can be stopped and started via one bit object, and we have also the status as a group object if the sequence is active or not. Like here, typical application, maybe here in a hotel, in a lobby, yeah, that here, maybe the color change very slow between red, green, blue, purple, and so on. So to activate the scenes, we go to our main menu, output A, configuration, and then you can also here activate the sequence, yes or no, like we do it for the scenes, emergency light converters, for groups, or for the individual ballast. And if you say here yes, then you will find here the four sequences, and then you can enable all four, or only maybe some one or two or three or four scenes. And then we come to the settings and can configure now our scene. Yeah, sequences. Now, what are typical examples of a sequence? Yeah, one example is that we can use it for human-centric lighting. So with human-centric lighting, we need color temperature ballast between warm and cold white, and we can simulate the color temperature of the sun outside the building. So like in the morning at 6 o'clock, we want to have a color temperature of, for example, 2700 Kelvin, and then in high noon, we want to have up to more than 6,000, and then it goes down maybe up to 2,700 Kelvins. And this is over one day, maybe, for example, from 6 o'clock in the morning up to 6 o'clock in the evening. And to do it exactly this behavior, we can use a sequence. Yeah? So we have use our 10 steps, number of cycle, only one cycle. So, and then we enter here the group number 7. This is, for example, my color temperature spot in my classroom or in my meeting room, for example, like here, a typical meeting room, no window. You see not the sun outside, but we want to have exactly this color temperature here. Then we can enter it here. We say the brightness should not be changed because we want to have the same brightness, but we want to change the color temperature. So then we select here, or we enter here the value from 2700 Kelvins, then 3000, 4000, 5000, 500, 6000, up to 6300 at high noon. And then we go here down up to 2700. The dimming time, 2 seconds or 5 seconds, not really important. But the step duration is here that we have per step 3600 seconds, which are 16 minutes. So every hour, the color temperature changes here automatically. So this is a typical example of a sequencer. And another one is, for example, here the color control and the color gradients. So like here for maybe for spa applications, yeah, you have here LED strips, RGBW, and the color changes here automatically from green to purple to blue to red. For example, all things are possible. So then we create here another sequencer, like my sequencer number 3, and I select here my group number 5, and I can enter here then the color value. Because group number 5, this is device type 8, color control RGBW, and then I can click here on this picker, he pops up, and I can enter here my color which I want to have, like we start with red, and then 1 minute later, orange, and then maybe yellow, and then it becomes to light green, dark green, yeah, blue and purple, and so on. And at the end, when I stop the sequencer, you see I have here cycle 0, it is running endless, no limited, then he goes to my end step and switches off the complete light of my group number 5. So this typical example here of a sequencer for RGBW controller. Good, then let's come to the so-called load shedding function. This is a new function we have in our switch actuator with energy functions, and of course in our energy actuator together with our load control master, the KNX Energy Analyzer QAS. The QAS, he sums up the power load from devices via the meter interface or energy actuator, and if the device maybe reaches here our load limit, then he sends shedding stations to the devices, to the switch actuator, to the energy actuator, and switch off some load. And what is now new, that we have also integrated the DALI gateway with this software version 2.0 in this load shedding. So then we can not switch off the lights. What we do, we limit the maximum brightness value. So if the shedding stage is active, we can define the maximum brightness of a group or with a DALI device to reduce the brightness and save energy. So we have given also numerous webinars about our energy analyzer QAS and the energy actuator and switch actuator with energy functions. You can visit Also here our training qualification database, and then you get here more impressions about these functions and the links, including to YouTube to see the videos. More information we will show in our further practical learning sessions, which follows maybe in some weeks. So then let's come to the so-called operating duration function. So with the operating duration, we can count the operating hour of some lamps. So this is maybe a requirement sometimes for the market, like here in the staircase or in some hospitals or here maybe some parking place, to count the operating duration, and if they reach a limit, maybe about 5,000 hours, to get an information that maybe there is a need for maintenance or to replace here the lamps, like in a hospital. Sometimes the requirement to replace it. So, but what is on? The best thing is that we get the information from the ballast that the device is switched on or not, and the ballast counts also this operating duration. But this is not a mandatory function of the ballast. So maybe you are not sure if this ballast can count the operating duration or not. This is not really specified, so not really sure. So what we have done is we have a look in the DALI gateway, and if the ballast or the group or the group is higher than 0% and there is no lamp or ballast fault, and then we count here this operating duration. So it's a kind of listen to the what happens on DALI, to the command, yes, switch on, it is on, and no lamp or ballast failure, and then we start our internal counter for this operating duration. So, and then we count it, and then you can read it out, or you can send it also on the KNX bus, these hours in different formats, in hours or seconds, and also via a threshold, we can set also here a limit. So we have here, for example, internal hours, for example, this is possible. So here we have the parameters. If you enable it, we go to the functions template, enable function operation, operating duration, if you say yes, then you can select, would you like to have it in hours, data point type with 2 bytes, 4 bytes, or also in seconds. And the next parameter is here to enable here the alarm function, and you can enter here a threshold. So if the device reaches here 10,000 hours, then he sends alarm message on KNX, and you know that you have to do maintenance, or you have to replace here your bulb or something. So, next nice feature is the name of ballast and groups. We have also here some maybe modifications. So this is not you. And you can give here a name of a group, maximum 40 characters, like Office 301, light strip left, or of an individual device, like here, storeroom. But this what is now new, that you see here on the left side in the tree of all your ballasts, of all your groups, also this text here. So this maybe helps you to have your overview of all your 16 groups or your 64 ballasts. But that's not all. When you have a look on the group objects, then you see group number 2, you read here also the same text, Office 301. So this is a really nice feature which helps you when you link group addresses to see, okay, this is the group address of my Office room 301, or here this is the group address for switching dimming brightness value here of my storeroom. But why it makes sense to enter here a useful name, user-friendly name, to a ballast or here to a group, because you see it here in the name of the group objects. So what else? We have also now the possibility to get the status if the color temperature function for tunable white, HCL, or dim to warm is now active. Before we didn't have this status, but now we made also update, and here we have also the status message. Good, then let's come to the enhancements of the ABB iBus tool, our diagnostic tool for commissioning for some devices, especially here for DALI. We have made here also some optimizations of the selection function. So let's come here to some features. So here you can see a screenshot of the page general. General, you get here an overview, how many DALI devices are connected to an output, how many monitored, conflict, and so on. And here with the DALI ballast selection, we can set a value, the brightness value, if you select a device later on the next page in a DALI overview. 100%, 80%, 50%. But now what is new, If an unselected device should not change the value, then you can change it now and say no change. Yeah, unselected typically was 0, off, or only 1 or 5%. But on the market sometimes, or doing commissioning, you want not to change the value of an unselected device. Like you have, for example, a DALI gateway. You have different floors, floor number 1, 2, 3, 4, some DALI, LED drivers in the floor number 1, number 2, number 3. So when you work or do commissioning on the floor number 3, and you select a device floor number 3, the other devices in floor number 1, 2, and 4 should not be affected. That's why you can say, okay, these unselected devices, the value should not change. A very nice parameter. Or for the emergency lighting converter. When you select emergency lighting converter, should direct by identification, for example, the light goes on, or by a function test, then it triggers a function test. So when you now select the device, you see here the brightness value, 100%, you can say also, how should this ballast react? It should switch on, or also dimming. When you say it should dim darker and brighter, then you have to enter here a fade time. When you say 0, then it switches on. If you say 1, 2, 3, 4 seconds, then he's dimming. Or for example, blinking. So when you say blinking, then it starts blinking with some with on and off signals. But do not forget, if you change your parameter, you have to click here on the button apply. That these values are really written here into the DALI gateway. Good, then let's come to the next page, the so-called DALI page. Here we have, here we'll see this optimizations with this selecting or not selecting. And what is also new is we have here the possibility to make a step-by-step communication, and we can fix now some ballast individual. So what does it mean? So at first we have here the possibility to select the device, and then when you click here on a device, and depending on the parameters we have made in the overview general, it goes to 100%, and the other devices, maybe they don't change the value which they have at the moment. So, and what else about our fixing? Fixing means what is now new is here a field where you, and here you can tick this field. So when you tick this field, and then the device is monitored. We have this new possibility, you can step by step change the address of a device, like here, you change the address to number 11, and then you can tick it, and then this device is now monitored, only this one with the number 11, and if you want to change the address by drag and drop, a message pops up, can't change address of a monitor ballast, because this device is monitored, and then you cannot change it. This helps you, for example, for commissioning. So maybe today you do the commissioning of the first 10 devices with address 1 to 10. And then you can tick all these 10 devices. And when your colleague tomorrow continues, and then he can see, number 1 to 10 is now here ticked. Okay, then he can continue with 11 and so on. So it gives you really an overview, and you can do this step-by-step commissioning. Of course, you can also press here the button trigger DALI device monitoring, then all devices will be monitored. But with this feature, you click on a device and you tick it here, you can do it really step by step. Good, and what also we have here the broadcast converter identification. You can also click here, and then the emergency converters goes on and shows you also the addresses. Good, very nice feature here, this ticking and fixing of a single device. In the overview menu, you can see here the name of this of the groups and the individual control ballast. At first you see here the text, office number 1, this is the text you can enter in the ATS of the groups, and you can see here also the text of some ballasts, not of all ballasts, because the ballast number 1 to 12, they are group oriented. So if you say 1 to 12 is linked to a group, and then you cannot enter here text. Only number 13, 15, 16, 17, these are individually controlled. That's why you can see here the text which was possible to enter in the ATS. Additionally, you can see the device type 0, for example, or device type 6, device type 8. 8, this is my tunable white, for example, in the classroom. This is my RGB. And device type number 1, number 25, this is the emergency lighting converter. You can set here the values, the brightness value, you can switch on and off, and you see here also some important information. More information you will see in the next page in the so-called detail. Detail here, you can select here a device, a single device, or also a group, group 1 to 16 or device 1 to 64. Then you see additionally here the text, like here in the entrance. Yes, okay, this is correct. And then you can see the status. If green is okay, you see the current brightness level. And here, if it's a color control device, device type 8, then you can see here also the color status. So with the right side, we have the field of color control. And here you can select the color like you want. So we have the sliders for RGB, red, green, and blue. You can mix the color like you want. Or if you prefer HSV, you can use these sliders from 0 to 360 degrees for UE saturation or here for the brightness value. And additionally, you have here for the color number 4 for the white one. So then you can mix the color like you want. And you see here also the values in hex of these four colors. And we get additional information about the parameterization. Like here in the ETS, we have enabled color function. And the device responds, yes, I'm color function. That's why we get here true, true. One is the parameterization. And the other one really is the feedback from the ballast. Good. And of course, some more information about the supported color control devices like temperature color or XIV, for example, and the four channels. This is the information we get here per device, per detail. So, and the last page is about the emergency converter. Here we have also some features, for example, now it, what is new that we support the switchable maintained converter. This is now new. And we see here with one column, the battery capacity and with the field test, we can select here test, the battery test, the function test or the partial duration test and also start here. And then you will see here the test status, if it's idle or running and the result, for example, successful or failed or something. Good, so far, this was the IWAS tool. Then let's come to the update of the firmware and ETS application. So at first, there is a firmware inside the DALI gateway, independent the ETS, and sometimes it's necessary to update the firmware. So at the moment, the latest firmware version of the DALI gateway is 0.0.16. If you have still 0.0.15, it doesn't matter. There is no need to make an update. Only if you have a very old DALI gateway premium with 0.0.13, then it makes sense to update the firmware. Update is possible via the so-called ETS app, which is available on the website of the KNX Association. And this app is downloaded and installed in the ETS, the so-called ABB Firmware Update 02 app. And with this firmware update, you can make an update of the DALI gateway, presence detector, some sensors, for example, the new switch actuator generation. All these devices can be the firmware can be updated of these devices. So you select here the device, and then you click here on apps, and then the app appears, and you can make the update. Of course, the app is free of charge, but you have to place an order, like always when you order an app. So then you select here your device, and then you get the information. For example, this is at the moment the firmware in the device 0.0.15, for example. Then you get here the information, the status. Yeah. Oh, there's an update possible to 0.0.16. And then you can click here on the button update firmware and then the update process starts. And at the end, you get here the information update was successful and you have the latest version in the DALI gateway in your presence detector on the other devices. So by using or by making such a firmware update, we have high traffic on our KNX twisted pair line. So it's recommended that the USB interface is in the same line. So it's not recommended to make a download via line couplers or area couplers because we have high traffic in all our lines. Best thing is you use USB interface, the latest one, version 1.2, which supports long frames, and then you can also make a faster download or via IP router or IP interface. So then we come to the update of the ETS application. So very important. We have two possibilities. One is that we can make a direct so-called update. So direct update means we have here an ETS. You add from your catalog a DALI gateway with the version 2.0 and you download this application. But when a download is started, the ETS checks the version of the device. And if you have a DALI gateway with the version 1.4, you get the information, okay, you want to download a version 2.0 and it will last some minutes and then you can click on the button yes. And then the former application version 1.4 is overwritten, including the parameterization and the group addresses are also deleted. So you have then really a brand new device, but you have lost all the information. That's why this kind of download is only recommended for a new device. So when you order it from the wholesaler and you get it with the version 1.4, then it makes sense, or it's the easiest way to do this upload. So, but now today, remember, the devices leave the factory with version 2.0, but if you have a old with 1.4, then you can do it in this way. Better is, you use the ETS app, Update, Copy and Convert. With this app, you can make a conversion from 1.4 to 2.0 application program, but all parameterizations, the group addresses, the parameters are now remained. So this kind of app is now recommended for devices, DALI gateways, which are installed in operation, and you want to use these new software functions, like RGB control, for example. It's not a bug fixing, so when the system is running and you need no more new functions, then you can still use the version 1.4 like before, never touch the system, only if you want to have new functions, yeah, like the operating durations or the sequencer, then please use this app and make an update, and all the parameterizations, including the group addresses, are now remain. So you go to the KNX Association, My KNX, download the app. The app is free of charge, and then with this app, you can make the update from 1.4, for example, to 2.0. So only two things happen after during the update: that the DALI group assignments and the device monitoring are lost. This is not based on the DALI gateway, because this information are stored in the ballast. But with the IBAS tool, we can restore the settings. So at the end, you lost no data and so on. So I show you now step by step how we can do this. Good, okay, then let's make here update. So when you have a project with a DALI gateway like here, 37100101 with the version 1.4, and you want to update it into the version 2.0 because you want sequencer functions, then you add from the catalog a device with the version 2.0 to your project, because then this is a kind of reference, yeah, for this update tool. And then you click on the device 37100101.4, you start the app, and in the app you select the device and click on the button update. And then this update process now starts step by step. You click here update, and then a window pops up. Yeah, shows here your reference device, which you have added from the catalog, 2.0. And then you click here on the device, on the button, start update, and then the update from 1.4 to 2.0 is now started. So you can do it per device, or you can also click here, update all devices within this application version. Then all of the DALI gateways in your project will be updated here automatically. Good, and then the update process is started. And at the end, you see here the DALI gateway has still the same address, 37101, and with the new application version 2.0. What you have to make? Only to download this new application program, including the parameters and the group addresses, to the device. The device has the same individual address, so you have not to go and press the programming button, because the address is still existing. You click only on the button download, and then the new full application 2.0 is downloaded into the device. Again, we have during this update a high amount of telegrams, so it's also recommended that you are with your USB interface in the same line, or you use, for example, IP router or IP interface to make a download via IP, because this device supports long frame telegrams, so we can reduce the time and the number of the telegrams. Good, after this download, remember the group assignment and the monitoring of the devices is now deleted. So what we have to do is we start the IBAS tool, and then in the IBAS tool, you get a message here on the main page, there's a conflict. And when you click on the DALI overview page, you can still see here your groups, including the names. You see here again your DALI devices, but you see there are no group assignments. So we can solve the problem when you go here to the button, I think here the next page, use DALI device values, and then the gateways reads out the address, the group assignment of all the ballast, and restore it. So we have not to do this group assignment again. We can read it out from the ballast, and then this conflict is solved. And the second step is we have to trigger the device monitoring again, because this eye here for monitoring a ballast, this is also lost during this process. Only here mouse click and wait some seconds, and then the monitoring is still active. Good, these are the steps we have to do here in our update and the IBAS tool. Good, so far I'm at the end of my presentation about a new software or new application program 2.0 for the ABB IBAS KNX DALI Gateway Premium DGS X6451. We will show you further information with practical examples, with the IBAS tool, and for example, to link group addresses between the RoomTouch and the DALI gateway in 3-byte in RGB or HSV in one of the following practical learning sessions. So far, I would like to say thank you for your participating, for listening, and I give now the word back to Thorsten.
Yeah, thank you, Jürgen. Allow me to contribute also some slides today, and I continue with some more marketing slides. Let's say what is available for these products in addition to the hard and software. So of course we have comprehensive documentation, consists of the product manual, installation and operating instructions, technical data, everything on our homepage in different languages. And of course in our catalogs, one is this typical product range overview catalog of all our KNX devices version from this year. You find also this product, also hint to the RGB control, hint to the additional functions. And another big catalog is an overview of all our electrical installation material, a lot of pages, and also ABB IBAS KNX is included. So a microsite exists for this DALI Gateway Premium, showing also the main features with very few text, but also pictures. You see here some screenshots. Here's also the link for you. And as always, for the product itself, which is not a new product you have learned, it's a really existing hardware. We have also our homepage with all the material around this product, including the new application, of course. It's already existing, so you can download this. And you know also how to update this, especially if you're already running a DALI Gateway Premium with group addresses and parameterization. So with our app, it's much easier to do this. You know that everything is also available here on our homepage regarding the training material we have created in the past. As mentioned by Jürgen, we have already a lot further, let me say, learning sessions about DALI. All these things are here on our training and qualification database. Before I come to the preview of the next sessions, allow me to summarize a bit I come to this right now, but allow me to summarize a bit about the main features. So we have not a new product, new hardware, existing hardware, premium, but a complete new application with a lot of extensions. So we have all the original functions, but in addition, this RGB control, where you need only one DALI address for the DALI ballast. The sequencer, I really like this because we had it already before in former devices, now also existing in the premium with these nice features. And if you have seen the part of the ETS programming, it's really nice to adjust this. Yeah? Every step you can adjust all the parameters you need, and that's very easy to create sequence functions. Load shedding, operation hours you can count, things like this. And the ABB IBAS tool extension also quite good, especially the fixing of the addresses makes commissioning much easier. So this was a feedback from the market, from our customers, to do this. And if you remember the selection of the color inside the IBAS tool to check the color, how is the quality of the color of your light, very easy and quite user-friendly. Okay, so again, we continue with some more sessions in July. Three are planned. Exactly these functions we have shown, more or less in theory, and only with very few slides in the ETS, would like to extend this a bit with a more practical approach. So we show also the real functions, not only how to program, but together with other components. And there will be three. Color control, then the sequencer and load shedding will be one session. And the topic of the operating hours and the IBAS tool options you have seen already partly. I say thank you for your participation. We have made it exactly, more or less exactly in 1 hour. Great. Hope to see you next time. Bye-bye. Ciao.